Hello, everyone. Welcome to my weekly live stream. My name is Christina Werner, and for tonight's live stream, I have, well, I kind of have three ideas, actually, so I might have those who are watching live take a quick vote. Excuse my keyboard here, because we're going to make it official. We're going to make it official with a vote. So let me go and find, hold on, I have to go over to YouTube and log in and find this live stream. Sorry, I should have this prepared, but it was kind of a last minute decision to like just have you vote. So, all right, here we go. I'm going to type the poll in. Okay, so you're choosing between, let's see, the vintage mosaics from Simon. I have kind of a fun idea that could be work with that. Folksy Cats, which I have not seen any examples of people using it the way that I designed it, like intended to, so I thought that'd be kind of fun. Or I have a, what's the word? Like a no stamps, dies needed watercoloring idea that I saw on Pinterest that I really want to try out. So those are going to be your options. What should I make? We've got, hold on, no one put anything in the chat. I'm going to have you actually vote. Okay, third option, easy watercolor. Okay. All right, for those of you who are watching live, you will now see some options on what to vote for. So put your votes in. I'm just going to sit here and watch it for a bit. And see what comes through. So I guess I can talk a little bit more about the ideas for this one. I think I was going to use watercolor with anyway. Stamp these and emboss them in white, and then do some watercolor for the top. I was thinking in like a really pretty cobalt blue, kind of like that traditional mosaic blue tiles. Ugh, I love those. Folksy Cats, we would be doing a little bit different stuff with it. So get all of your votes in right now. And we'll see right now, currently Folksy Cats is winning. So I'm going to look up, because I have an image of the what I intended for the Folksy Cats to be. I have an image. So I just got to look it up. To make sure I have the whole idea. So I'm just gonna find it really, really quick. I have to go back to when I originally designed this, and I can actually tell you the date of when I designed it. This came out from Simon's Stamp about a week and a half ago. So currently still Folksy Cats are in the lead. Okay, is this the one? No. Hold on. Still looking. I have to go find all this. Okay, it might be this one. Nope. Okay, hold on. I didn't realize we've had so many... so many design deadlines since I designed this one. Okay, hold on. I have to like look through all my emails. Okay, this has got to be the one. Yeah, this has got to be the one. It's not. Okay, still looking. Hold on. See her. All right, I'm just gonna have to look up Folksy Cats. Maybe it'll pop up in an email. Oh yeah, that looks like that would be it. Hold on. Oh my gosh, I wish I had found this before we were where we're going here. Okay, there we go, found it. Okay, so And I guess I could just like show you guys the examples because I came up with quite a few. So, and it does look like Folksy Cats is the winner. Okay, so I'm going to end the poll. And then I came up with this mock-up of all the different things you could do with it. So we might do two different designs. We'll get there. I'm just going to bring that up on my phone so I have it. Okay, Folksy Cats it is. Let's go ahead and play with this. The live viewers have voted, and we are playing with Folksy Cats from Simus' Stamp. And I'm going to show you something that I don't know if anyone's picked up on yet. So I've got my handy dandy stamp positioning tool here. And I'm going to go pick out some colored cardstock. Let's go with some Concord and Ninth cardstock. So maybe like a nice teal or something like that. Tidepool. Yeah. We're going to do Tidepool. And then I'm going to stamp in Juniper. Hold on. I'm just going to cut my cardstock down so it's a little bit easier to handle inside my MISTI. Okay. All right. So here is the lovely cardstock. I'm going to put it on a stamp and stencil mat from Simus' Stamp so that I can put it in my MISTI and have it stick to the center, and I can stamp past the edges. Okay, so the Folksy Cat stamp set. If you use the really large frame design that's included, we're going to put that about right there. Get that kind of, actually, we're going to come up a little higher and have it go off the top edge. I don't know if, yeah, we're going to have to stamp them separate. Okay. So first I'm going to stamp this right here. Get that in the corner. I'm going to use Juniper. I think these colors look really great together. It's very monochromatic. And I've never stamped with this stamp before, so I might need to stamp it twice to get a really good impression. We'll find out. Yeah, I will, because the ink is sort of beating up on it. Yeah, we want something really solid. So I'm going to stamp this again. This is the joy of using a MISTI. Those of us who have been stamping for a long time, remember the days when you stamped once and that was the only shot you got. Okay. Okay, that's a little bit more solid. I'll go with that. Let me grab my... Of course, it's hard as a rock. Well, I have my bucket of water here because I was almost doing watercolor today. So I'm going to go ahead and dunk my stamp chamois in to my bucket of water. And then we'll clean off my stamp. Julie, I don't know if anyone said it before, but Julie is on the right track. Clean up this stamp here. I have not seen anyone stamp the cats inside the frame. Mostly because I think on the stamp set it has the greeting inside of it. So I think people are like, oh, only the greetings go inside the frame. No, no, my friends. It was purposely designed to fit the cats. It was a last minute design decision to remove the cats out of the whole design and make it so you could put other things in it as well. So the cats fit perfectly inside the little frame. So here's here we go. Ink that up with Juniper. And I'll stamp this twice so it has the same intensity as all the frame elements. Ah, love it. Love it already. I'm gonna do one more to get them really solid. In fact, if you wanted to, you could emboss in gold or something like that, and then it helps them really stand out. Okay, that's super solid now. I love that. Clean up my little stamp. And then we can move on. And this first card is going to be super, super simple. It's mainly just the background stamping and then a die cut sentiment. So this card design is going to come together really quickly. And then we'll move on to one of the other things that I mocked up for this stamp set. All right, so on my example, I used the die set So Happy For You Both. So I'm going to grab that. Thankfully, I think I have it right here in my stash. Or maybe I don't. I don't know. Found it. Okay, so this one is So Happy For You Both. And I'm going to take my wire cutters or the die cutters, and I'll just snip this so I can use the pieces separately. Okay. I don't remember what I did in my example. I think it was gold. I don't remember. No, it was just like the darker shade. So I'll just grab some Juniper cardstock. Grabbing some. I have this whole stack of Concord and Ninth cardstock that's already been cut down. So we'll just find the Juniper. Oh, it's at the bottom. There's Juniper. That looked really nice. And I'm going to cut out the So Happy For You. Just run this through my die cutting machine. Oh, it looks like it didn't cut all the way through. I think my plates are getting a little worn. So I'm going to run it through again, but I'm just going to put another piece of cardstock as a shim. Hopefully that'll be enough. I don't think that cut all the way through. Oh, well, maybe it'll be okay. I mean, the main area cut. I don't know about this interior. Yeah, it really didn't. Let's try. Oh, I don't want to waste any more cardstock. I will use an X-Acto knife. It looks like there just might be a couple spots that are hanging on. This tells me I need new cutting plates and mats, because this should not have any issue cutting out. I think it's mostly just this one spot. See if that was enough to get it out. Oh, I've got one little spot that's looking like it's fraying. Come out. I'm planning to put it on top of white, so it will most definitely show. Everything else seems to be popping out okay. It's just that one little area. Right in the center. The things we do for intricate dyes, right? You're like, no, I refuse. I have to use it. Okay. All right, finally got it. Well, I have other plates that I could replace that with. I just don't have to go grab them all. Let's try cutting out just the white. This shape, the shadow should be just fine because it's not anything too crazy. But I kind of do want to pop up the So Happy For You Both. I want it to be a little more substantial. So we'll see. Maybe cutting that into the magnetic mat will be a little bit better. Let's try that. We'll just see if we can cut into the magnetic mat, if that'll do it a little better. Usually it's the other way around. You do the magnetic mat and it doesn't cut, so then you switch to the cutting plate and then it will cut. So we'll see. No, it's totally my mats. Look at this. The white didn't even cut. Okay, well, time for to swap out my mats. And thankfully, Angel Casey organized my craft room and I know exactly where to go. So I need a new... See, I've got all the pieces I need. I don't necessarily have to replace that one, but I do need a new cutting plate. And then I need a new magnetic mat. All right, and then these two that I've been using are going to the big craft room in the sky. And then we'll continue on. I do love a nice brand new magnetic mat. All right, and you know, since I do want to kind of stack these up anyway, I'm going to go ahead and grab more Juniper cardstock. Daphne! Wow, Daphne's freaking out. Daphne, what are you doing? What are you doing? Hi. Just cutting down that cardstock so that it's easier to use. Hi, Daph.
Hi.
Okay, so here's Juniper. I'm gonna do the So Happy For You Both up here. Let's try cutting it again. In fact, you know what? Instead of having it go sideways, well, no, this is a brand new plate. It'll be fine. Put it right there. I have this older plate that's kind of, well, it'll stay in the bottom. And let's run that through. I'm also going to reverse it and see, like running it through twice, if that helps, because, oh my gosh, it still didn't get that. I didn't replace both plates. Let's test this. I'm going to go this way, this direction now. Maybe add a diagonal, because this die should really not be any problem. Come on, Empress. You can do it. What in the world? I don't think it cut through again. I've never had such problems. All right, well, let's build up some shims around that and cut again, because this is really frustrating me. Do two layers of cardstock right there. Just right there. see if that helps. Oh, because this is ridiculous. Okay, that looks like it cut all the way through this time. Absolutely. It just needed more pressure. No problem. Look how easy. I guess it just needs more pressure. So here we are. And now I can just use the same cardstock but slide it up because I can see where it's coming through. And here I thought this was going to be a really easy card. I do need full sheets of the white though, so it doesn't curl up as I run it through. The machine is like, why are you sending so much paper through? It's because you're not cutting it otherwise, girl. Okay. Pop that out. One more time. Two pieces of white cardstock. Run this through again. Why aren't you going through? Oh! The paper went through on its own. Okay, let's try that again. I'll just turn it around. I'm not going to get a fourth bit out of this anyway. Okay. There we go. And then I've already got that one that I cut out earlier, so then we'll have four layers. Once again, that cut through without any issues. All right. Then I'm going to grab a little bit of white cardstock, and we'll do our lovely little outline shape. And because I'm paranoid, I'm going to put those shims through at the same time again, although I really don't need to think it needs it. We'll see. Hi, Brenda. Yes, I will have to combine May and June mail calls together. Getting COVID, that messed me up. And I'm still struggling to get all the way back to catching up. So here we are. So yes, the May and June mail call videos will be combined. Generally, I don't have any issues with my Empress. I think maybe it's just a combination of plates and just needing more shims, you know? Every once in a while, I just need more shims. Where is my little pokey tool? Sika, where's my pokey tool from last week? It has wandered off. Oh, wait, okay. Well, I guess I'm using my craft knife. Oh, wait, isn't there a Simon pokey tool? There is. Let me find it. Haha. There we go. I was looking for my Tim Holtz one, but then I remembered that this tool, this is like the Place and Pierce tool, I think is what they call it, from Simon Says Stamp. And poke out all these little interiors. I really like to stack four die cut greetings because I think that gives you like a substantial, really hefty greeting. So let's see. Oh yeah, that's gonna look great. Poke that little guy out. That's gonna look awesome. Nice and thick. Jenny, Greg took it. I wouldn't put it across past Greg, but he hasn't been to my house in the last week. Okay. So to put all of these together, I'm going to use some Honeybee precision glue, and I'm going to grab my tweezers. And what I like to do, I'm going to save this one for the top. These other three need glue. And I'm going to try to glue them all fairly quickly. We'll see how well I can do this. But little dabs of glue. Just kind of all over. I'm putting it on the front. Sometimes I like to put it on the back, but today I'm just feeling the front. So I'll get one done and just place that one right on top. Pick them up, make sure it's kind of lining up. You can kind of smush them around a little bit. And then I'm going to put more glue on top. If there's any squidging out, I don't worry about it because this glue dries clear. And I just discovered that if I try to clean up all the glue that kind of presses out, all I'm doing is making a mess of my fingertips and whatever tool I'm using to do that. So I just stopped doing it. And it never really shows on my final card. Like, you'd have to be looking pretty closely to see any glue hanging out, you know? Y'all, I got Sika hooked on Dazzle Dry Nail Polish, and she sent me a picture of her nails that she just did yesterday. So gorgeous. She used the most beautiful shimmery red. Gorgeous. All right, so last layer. So now I have this all thickened up. It's nice and substantial. Let me zoom in for you. You can see quite a bit of the glue kind of peeking out. I'm not going to worry about it. Now for this last one that goes on top of the white shadow, this is when I go to the back. You just need enough to hold it to the white. So like not a ton, but like I try to get like, you know, at least the top and bottom of every letter. And then this is going onto the white. Got some little fuzzy hairy bits from the first time I die cut it, but not a huge deal. All right, the white glue doesn't even show on top of the white cardstock either. Okay, not entirely centered perfectly, but I'm gonna take my paperweight from Jennifer McGuire. Actually bought from, what is it? Is it Jossy Bossy Bossy Jossy? I can't remember, but you can go get your paperweight from over there. Yeah, Share Handmade Kindness. Put that right there. I'm going to glue this piece to a card base while all of those layers dry. Grabbing a prepared card base from my drawer, and I'm just going to use some Tombow Extreme adhesive on my stamped card front. I'm going to check the fold, make sure I'm putting it on right, and then directly down onto the card front. Okay, this is pretty dry by now. And then it's just going to go right there at the bottom. And I'm just going to do some of this adhesive. Hold it with my tweezers. And then directly onto the card. Perfect. Okay. I'm going to kind of clean up some of these little fuzzies because I'm thinking I want to do some glossy accents. They're just a few little fuzzy parts, like not bad. I want to do glossy accents because I think having a little bit of shine on this would be really, really pretty. So here we are, glossy accents. And I wonder if I can put put this? No, I'm not gonna worry about it. I was gonna try to put it over the top so I don't go too far. Oops. But I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm just gonna go ahead and start applying the glossy accents. But I do want to kind of get the bubbles out on a piece of scratch paper. And then I'm just gonna start applying. And I just squeeze a little bit, stop squeezing, and then kind of smear it around. Because the amount that goes onto the cardstock when you're squeezing is most likely too much. So you can like stop squeezing and kind of spread it around. It self-levels, so it always looks really great once you kind of have it on edge to edge. And hopefully this will have time to dry while we finish the other card, and then you can see it all glossy. When glossy accents goes on, it does look a little bit cloudy at first. So it looks like it changes the color of whatever's underneath it. But as it dries, it will dry perfectly clear. It also doesn't dry as plumped up as it looks at first. But my friend Kathy Rakusin, she is like the queen of glossy accents to me. She will put something on, like put glossy accents on something. She will spend like a week just putting more and more layers on it to let it dry in between until the actual finished project looks all plumped up and glossy like this. And it's amazing. She's very patient with it. It looks awesome. Okay, so here we go. Here's this first card. Got like this little thing right there. Okay, I'm gonna set this aside somewhere safe that nothing's gonna happen to it while I'm working on our other card. All right, so there's card one. Took about a half hour. Probably would have been less if I didn't have any issues die cutting. Like, let's be real. I think I spent about 10 minutes just figuring out die cutting. Okay, so let me look at my mock-ups of other cards. Some other things that I thought would be really, really cute. Okay. Oh, yeah. That'll be really cute. Okay. So now the stamp set has all of these little individual flowers, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stamp the main frame on some cardstock, and then I'm going to die cut all of these little individual pieces and stamp and die cut them, and then we can pop them up and really make this whole frame very colorful. That's the plan. Let me see if I can zoom in on this card that I'm thinking of. So it would look a little bit, oh my word, let's hold this up here. It would look more like that card right there. It's kind of hard to see. My phone is very bright. There you go. Right there. So I'm going to come grab some colors. Looks like I've got 4 colors and then a brown. So let's see. We want purple, pink, nice orange, and let's do like a green. Like a yellow. Well, it's a yellow. Yeah, those will be cute. Okay. And then brown. Alrighty. So I picked out my colors from Simus's stamp. And we're going to do a bunch of stamping now. Okay. The colors I've chosen are Sweets, Violet, Sherbet, Sunbeam, and then I've got Mocha. Just getting all these things out of the way over here so I can do all of my stamping. It looks like I need a very light gray card base. And I'm gonna bring back my stamp and stencil mat. We're going to be stamping our card like that, and going back to my Concord and Ninth cardstock colors, think this is the color Pebble. I think that'll be perfect. It's a nice gray. Kind of a very pale, warmer gray. So I'll put that down right there. It's interesting, I'm gonna do gray with brown on top. So I'm getting the frame. And once again, I'm going to have it hang off the edge. I can still see little bits of green ink. Hopefully it won't transfer. All right, just like that. Pick up the stamp. And I'm gonna just clean it off a little bit again, just to make sure I have all that green off from earlier. And I'm coming in with Mocha. I'm kind of anticipating needing to stamp this twice. We'll see. Oh, that actually looks pretty good on the first stamp, and we're going to be covering this area that didn't stamp very well anyway. I'm going to go ahead and stamp it twice just to be sure. Beautiful. All right, and that brown will actually dry back just a little bit lighter than it's showing. Okay, put the stamp back on the stamp sheet. Alrighty, I'm gonna take this off the stamp and stencil mat. Roll back the mat so your cardstock doesn't warp. I always save the plastic sheet that goes on top so it doesn't get any dust on the sticky mat. So I'm going to save that, set that aside. Then I've got some white cardstock here. And let's see. I'm referring back to my lovely little, mock-up of the card. So I basically need, let's see, I need this flower, and I also need the heart, and I need the three hearts. Okay. For the dark pink, that's what I need. And then I'll stamp the greeting in the dark pink as well. I'm gonna need two of these, of each one. So the color sweets, making sure that's in the bottom corner of my MISTI, because I'm gonna stamp it twice. Then I'm gonna rotate it. Stamp this twice as well. I can clean that off. You know what? I think I'm missing another pink, so I'm gonna have to go grab that. There's a little heart. Oh wow, I needed the little heart, not the big one. Okay, that's okay. We'll get this taken care of. There's like all these other little pieces, and I just stamped the wrong one, that's all. So we'll do that one right there. In fact, if you wanted to, you could stamp all of the pieces and then cut them all out, and then just decide on the fly as you're actually arranging it which ones you want to use, you know? I need to re-ink this ink pad. It's getting low. Okay. Put that one aside. I'm going to take the... I'm going to do Thinking of You. And I'm going to stamp this a couple of times because I know I'm not going to have a super inky stamping because my ink pad is getting a little dry. Not bad, but I feel like it needs more. I love sweets. I think it might be one of my most used colors of the new Pawsitively saturated inks, which really aren't that new anymore. They've been out for a while. Okay. Before we move on, gonna take that little itty bitty heart stamp again, and I need two, but in a lighter pink. So I'm gonna grab Bubblegum. And we'll just stamp this twice in Bubblegum. Bubblegum is such a nice color. I don't use it very often, but it's really nice, actually. Nice pale pink. Okay. Let's do some orange flowers. And we'll do right here. And I also need, let's see, what else is orange on this? It's these big ones. Just like that, perfect. Oh, I should have picked it up. There we go. So now I'm using the color Sherbet. I don't think I even need to stamp that twice. But I am going to rotate that. I think, yeah, that's spaced well enough. Because I need two of these as well. Alrighty. Alright, we've done our orange. Let's do our purple. Just one purple, so we'll just do it right here. And I'm using the color violet. I have used violet a lot, so I need to re-ink. I need to just place an order for all of the re-inkers for these ink pads. I don't have them. I need to go order them. Okay, so there's violet. And then we just need our yellow. Oh, yeah, just the yellow, which is, we're gonna need two of those and then two of these smaller ones. So I think we're gonna be able to get all of this on one sheet, which will be great. Oh, I missed this. I missed some purples. We're gonna have to do more purple here in a minute. Using the color Sunbeam. Oh, that's a bright yellow. I think I'm gonna be able to rotate that, so I'm just gonna go ahead and grab another piece of white cardstock and not worry about it. Oh, looks like I need this one two more times. You know what? I'm going to have those be purple since I have to stamp purple anyway. So I'll just do that one, and then I need this larger one, both of those in purple. I love the color violet. I am not even opposed to adding more purple to the card design. Rotate that. I just need two more. Okay, I think those are all the pieces we need. Oh, my stamp timer just fell back in my water bucket. Hold on. I have to wring it out. Oh my gosh, my hand is like all green now. Hold on. From all that juniper ink. Okay. Yes, Wendy just said this would have a fantastic rainbow effect. Absolutely. I think that was that one of my examples? It may have been that I thought about, but I didn't use for this. So now we're going to die cut a bunch of these. All right, so I've sat back down and we're going to do a bunch of die cutting. Thankfully, I have the coordinating dies. So I'm going to cut these apart. Because I've not used this set before. Almost lost that one. There we go. All right, and then I've got to cut out, oh gosh, all these little pieces. So I'm going to cut it from this larger frame first. It's got a lot of connecting points. Like every single image on that stamp set, including the greetings, are included on the dies. So this is a really big die set. Okay, there we go. And I don't necessarily need that really large piece there, but I do need all these little interior pieces. So I'm gonna get these separated, and then I can go through, and if they've got any really sharp points, I can snip those off as well. Like doing die surgery. You know, generally I don't mind separating all of these dies, but I do really love the companies that already have them separated for you. It's real nice, like Concord and Ninth and Honeybee. I can't think of any others right now off the top of my head that do that. Spellbinders, when they already have them separated. Okay. All right, so now I'm gonna put everything into a trash, like I'm gonna lean into a trash can and snip off any of the longer pieces. And with my whole arm in the trash can, generally nothing's gonna go flying and possibly cause injury. So unfortunately, I'm going to be off camera for a moment. While I just snip all of these off. Technically, I don't need to spend the time doing this for what I'm doing today because it's not like I'm cutting off or die cutting anything where the interior has these little nubs. The only one that is kind of like that is this one right here. But even so, that's not that bad. Oh, Ulta New. Yes, Gina K. Sizzix. Yeah. I wish Simon would do the same. It'd be so great. All right, I'm just continuing doing this. Getting all the little pieces. Thankfully, I have a really, really tall trash can, so I can just put my whole arm in it. And what's interesting is this trash can, it's got to be at least like 25 years old. It's a trash can that we had when I was a teenager. And years ago, when my mom moved out of state, she's since come back. She lives with us now, now that she's retired. Anyway, when she left, I kind of inherited this trash can. And it's like a tall one that has like one of those kind of rounded lids that you can open and close. And I've just used it in my craft room ever since I started crafting. All right, just a couple more, and then we're done here. All right, and while I'm on a roll here, I'm just gonna go ahead and do this cat. We're not die cutting it today, but while I'm doing it, I might as well. Should say cats, multiple. Okay. And this one right here. Okay. Now we can get to all of this die cutting. Now I'm going to be die cutting directly into my magnetic plate because I can actually see where things are sitting. So I'm going to try to do as many of these at the same time as I can. Does that match that image? It sure does. Okay, and then we've got the larger of the two. And then we have this little image. And we don't need this larger heart. We just need the smaller ones. Sorry if my head's getting in the way. Let's see. We've got the three hearts. And the large tulip shape. And this little dude. And also the smaller one of these. Hopefully those are pretty centered. Oh, I could do the thinking of you. I think that'll fit okay. We'll get it on another pass. I think it's gonna touch that yellow one a little bit too much. So we'll get that on another pass. And that through my die cutting machine. All Gorgeous. And I'll just get one of my little dishes where I keep all my die cuts so I don't lose any. I will say crafting with longer nails is a little bit of a challenge. I don't know if I'm able to let my nails get much longer than this just because I can't do anything. All right. Get that other little heart again. We need these other three down here. And then this one is this smaller one. And then that is not, is it this one? It might be this one. Yeah, it is. Now I have Sophie downstairs crying. Sophie! She doesn't know where she's at. Come on, Soph. All right. Get this bigger one right here. And then we can do the thinking of you. That on there just right. Okay. Run that through. For the most part, I'm glad all of these cut out pretty centered on the images. Like sometimes you just don't even know if when it goes through your die cutting machine if it's going to be centered just right, you know? All right, we've got, you know what? I'm going to cut this because then we can get this other one at the same time. I'll go through just like that. And then we've got this little guy and this one. And then the larger one. Run that through. Sika, have you shared a picture of your nails anywhere besides the one you sent me? I mean, I might out you and show everyone the photo. Because they're so pretty. It's such a good color. I actually have that color on order right now. Should be coming in my next Dazzle Dry order. Okay. Run that through. And then we'll just have one more little tiny flower to get. Is telling, I can show you the picture. Okay, hold on. Since I'm done die cutting, I will show you all the picture of Sika's nails. She says that she hasn't been painting her nails for years because she can't deal with the drying time of regular polish. So she's been loving Dazzle Dry. So I think this is only her second time using Dazzle Dry. Her first manicure, gosh, well, she just changed her nails yesterday. And she'd painted them on the previous Friday. So it had been like a good 9 days. Yeah. Tell us how it went, Zika. 9 days of growth on your nails. How did it all look? Like, did it chip much? All that. All right, I'm just getting all of these dyes back on my magnetic sheet here. Sophie, come here. These back in before I lose a die. Sophie. Okay. So I'm going to start assembling all of this. I'm going to put it on a card base. Oh, that is stamped so crooked. That's not just me, right? Yeah, that is really crooked. Look at this. Like, how crooked is it? Oh, it's just barely off. You know, I could fix that with a paper trimmer. It's barely off. I'm gonna fix that. I'll be right back. Okay, I think I squared it up a little bit better. It's just gonna be a little smaller than A2 now, but I'm pretty sure that's a little more straight now. It's still a little off, but it's closer. Close enough. And then when I adhere it, I'll just adhere it up into the corner with the fold, and then I can trim it off. Zika's nails. Okay. Y'all are gonna die. They look so good. Look at that. Her nails look so good. Isn't that color gorgeous? I love it so much. Remind us of the color, Zika. Is it Seduction? Is that what it is? I can't remember. Checking where the fold is. Put that right up on the fold. And then I can use a ruler and a craft knife. My drawer really doesn't want to close. There we go. A ruler and a craft knife to get this cut out and lined up just right. Everything moved. Okay, so now we've got all of our little die cut pieces. And I'm going to use, let's see, I want regular foam adhesive. And my big foam roll has walked off. I don't even know how that's possible. It is so big. I have no idea where it went. Yes, Seduction from Dazzle Dry. I don't even know how my foam walked off. I mean, Sika knows how big that roll was from last week. Where did it go? Oh my gosh, it's like all the way across the room. Okay. You know what? I bet like Jennifer picked it up or something. I'm gonna blame Jennifer. That just goes to show that I have not been in my craft room since the last live. And it's because I've had lots of design deadlines. All right. Here we go. Put a little, where'd my scissors go? They were just here. Here they are. I'm gonna cut a really thin piece of foam to go on this T. Let me just pop this right up in the center. Let's see here. Yeah, that works right there. All right, so now I just have to put foam on the back of all of these little pieces. This is when I wish I had a bunch of little foam pieces already cut. So we're gonna do that right now using this foam tape. And then we can just start placing them directly over the top of the same images that are already stamped. So I'm just going to take my foam tape. I'm going to cut a little bit more than half on one side. I don't think I'm going to need too much of this. Maybe like that. And then I can cut some squares that will fit the larger pieces. Like right in the center of that one. That one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 more big pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I do have some little foam squares that I probably could have used, but it's all good. Now we just have a bunch of little ones. So I'm gonna go to the thinner strip and we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then there's some little ones that just cut too. And then it'll just be a matter of assembling these on the card. Some of these are so tiny. Like it might be easier to put the foam on the card and then put the image on top. All right, one more little heart. This little guy right here too. And then I have these two heart strips. Okay. And I probably should have zoomed in so you guys could see what I was doing better anyway. So here we are. So now I just have to place these right over the top of the images that are already there. So that goes right there. Hey, Dee. Oh. What brand has nonstick scissors? Well, this nonstick scissors I'm using today are from EK Success. I know you were asking Andrea that, but I will answer. Let's see. Put that right there. And then I can put the tulip up here at the top. Pink flower there. And pink flower there. So many little images. It should not surprise me how many there are considering I had to die could well. So, right, okay, hold on. I'm just referring to my example over here again. Okay, so the little purple ones are going right here. And orange are going down here. Must be the other orange one, sure enough. Daphne! Oh my word, she's got the zoomies. Daphne, come here. I don't think she's gonna come visit us, but maybe I can convince her. Daphne! Putting that one right there. We're down to just the last few. Purple right there. I'm gonna fill in this little gap right here with an extra yellow. So I needed some extra little guys. And then we've got pink right there and another pink right there. The other purple. And then, oh no, I think I lost a heart. Or maybe I just didn't even cut it out. I don't know. But we have a pale pink right there. Did I lose a heart somewhere? I cut it out, right? It was on the the smaller piece because this was here and I cut that. So where's the little piece? Uh-oh, am I gonna be die cutting, stamping or die cutting another little heart? I might have to be. All right. I don't know where that little one went. Is such a small little die cut. Okay, all right. Apparently I didn't cut it. Oh, I didn't cut it and I just found the piece in my trash. Yeah. Ha ha, it's right there. All right, well, it can be salvaged. It can be salvaged now. So I'm gonna die cut this last little one. Sure enough, Terrence is correct. I did not die cut it. So here we are. We'll get this last little one. Make sure it's centered. There we go. Thanks, D. Okay. Put my little tiny die back on the sheet before I lose it. And then I can take a little itty bitty piece of foam tape. On the back of the little heart. And then it'll go right there. Okay, not bad. I mean, a little time consuming for that card. 45 minutes beginning to end. Not too bad. All right, let's look at the first card that I did. Looks like it's pretty much dry. It's not quite as plumped up anymore. Can you see that? But I love how shiny it is. So those are the cards for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. I showed a couple different ways to use the Folksy Cats stamp set. Originally when I designed them, it was so you could have the cats within the center area. And then as the stamp set moved on and progressed with ideas, I popped out the cats and put in greetings and made it so you could stamp it without the cats inside. But also, just so you know, like the whole motif with the cats and everything, you can actually repeat it and it looks really, really pretty as a big pattern. Let me show you the mock-up. Let me see here. Do I have one where it shows it? Yeah, this one over here kind of shows it, that you can use it as a background and repeat it over and over again. Here it is if you stamp the cats in a different color. You can do that right there. And then I had this mock-up up here where you have the cats stamped on their own with, you know, a little greeting underneath. Here it is all in gold, and I've repeated the images over on the side as well, you know, so it finishes off the whole thing. So this one, look, it looks like I did the frame and then I stamped the frame again up at the top, and then also on the side I just filled it in all the gaps. So there's a lot of options for this really large kind of frame motif, a lot of different things you can do. So ta-da, I love doing that. I love like coming up with designs with the stamps that I create, and then I can create them in paper. I think it turns out really great. So I'm going to do a little spiel for those who are watching the edited replay, and then I'll answer a few questions here at the end. So here are the finished cards. Thanks so much for joining me today. You can get the stamps, dies, inks, cardstocks, everything I use today are over at simonsstamp.com, and specifically the individual cardstock colors are available at concordandninth.com. Thanks so much for joining me. I will see you guys probably in a mail call video. I'm combining the May and June mail call cards into one video, so I'll be filming that tomorrow and then sharing it with you very soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. Okay, so any questions? I didn't look at the comments very much tonight because I was really occupied with stamping and die cutting and all that. So I know I probably missed some questions. So if you have any questions that I missed, now is the time. Wendy Jean has a really good little tip. I love using the little sticky mats to hold my small die cuts. That's a great idea. Like, use one of the small, maybe for like the mini MISTI, something like that. That would be amazing. Such a good tip. This is the live of lost items tonight. Yes, Andrea, you are correct. It is. Let's see. Sika, the mail carrier just dropped off a dazzle dry mini flight and the remover that Christina recommended. Between nails and crafting, I will never be able to retire. It's a burden. Absolutely. Swill was the word. Oh, what is this swill? Yeah, I think I said that for the dill pickle taffy. That reminds me. When Sika and Jennifer were here, we ended up going to a local candy shop, and Sika and I bought a big pack of taffy, like an assorted pack of taffy, and then split it. And last night I was like, oh, I'm going to have some taffy. So I went to the bag, I pulled a piece out, and I about gagged. It was not dill pickle flavored, but it was cinnamon flavored. And when I had COVID and I was taking the antiviral, the only thing that would lessen the bad taste in my mouth was cinnamon candy. And I ate so much cinnamon candy over the course of that 5 days that I cannot. I put that back in the bag. I did not eat it. My husband's gonna have to eat it. Oh, Lisa said, I received my giveaway package that I won from your purge. It was awesome. So many items. Thank you so much. You're so welcome. Happy crafting. Okay. Oh, wait. Don't forget price of stamps go up on July 9th. Postage stamps? Are we postage stamps? I'm assuming. There's a few sets I need to buy. Sika. Oh, I forgot to warn you about the cinnamon. It was so spicy. Yeah. We'll see. I mean, I was eating like the extra hot tamales candies. Oh, that was intense. Let's see here. What is this? Andrea, our resident raccoon is out eating the food we put out for our feral cats. I'll have to go out and bring the food in after this live. Sigh. Oh, silly raccoon. Too funny. Does anyone have any other questions? Otherwise, I think I'll wrap this up because I've got to go edit it to the replay as well tonight before I head to bed. I'm not sure what this person's name is. It's not coming through. but this person said, I like that magnetic mat so you don't have to use tape. Absolutely. Everyone's giving me tips on where to find that. Find the missing heart. Let's see here. Someone's like, I hear a cat crying. Yes, Daphne is very extra vocal tonight. Dee, hi, Christina. I miss Utah. Come back, girl. I mean, I know you're in the middle of a big move, but you could come back. Jill says, love the white nails. You know what? I'm not sure how I feel about them. My hands are pretty pale, so generally, like, super light colors don't look the best. I don't know. I'm enjoying it. It's the first time I've had like white nails. So I'm trying it out. We'll see. Amber, I think I emailed you. I wondered if your MISTI arrived. I think I emailed you. Let me look. Yeah, emailed you Friday. Let me know. Did your MISTI arrive? The tracking says it looked like it reached you, but I just wanted to make sure. So, let's see. Does Be Creative glue really dry matte? I don't know that I have Be Creative glue. I have Honeybee, and that one, it does not dry matte. I think it's like a clear, but it does have a little bit of shine to it, if I remember. Oh, Elena, that's so sweet of you. First time watcher, you have a very soothing presenter's voice. I will be back. Well, thank you. That's very nice. And welcome. Sika, Utah, next week. Yeah. Get your butts on a plane and come out here. Okay. Oh, Pam, thank you for reminding us COVID is still out there. Glad you're better. Yes, COVID is still out there. And I think my husband and I are lucky that we've had it recently because we went to our family reunion and a few people got COVID after. So we're pretty lucky because we, you know, after you've had COVID, you're pretty like immune for, I mean, they say up to 90 days, but it can be lower than that. It can be less than that. So I'm glad that, you know, that worked out and everyone seems to be okay now. So we're all good. Let's see. Geraldine says, do we know if the international postage rate is going up, like to and from Canada? You know what? I would assume yes, if the postage rates for forever stamps are going up, but let me check. Let me look. Let's see, USPS postage stamps price increase and see what they say. Someone says they're going up in July. They might be. Okay. 2023 postage price changes. This is from USPS.com. Let's see what it says. These changes are to take effect July 9th. Oh, you can't even read that. To July 9th, 2023. Shipping services price changes. So, okay, what does it say? Okay. First class letters, so put forever stamps are going to go up to 66. International letters, it looks like it's going up 5 cents. 5 cents as well for postcards. International. Okay. Yeah, so everything's going up just a few cents. Looks like the prices mostly affect first class mail. So you're like 1 ounce, 3 ounce type issues. So yeah. Oh, good. Amber, I haven't checked my email. Yes, it arrived. I'm over the moon. I sent you a card, but our postage here is off at the moment, so maybe while getting to you. Oh, good. I'm so glad it arrived. I never know when I'm sending international. Those of you might remember in a live a while back, Amber was asking about an alternative to a MISTI, and I told her I would just go ahead and send her one of my old ones. So I mailed it to her, and she's over in Europe, so it took a while. But I'm so glad it arrived because I wasn't sure if it would be okay because I just like put it in bubble wrap and then into a padded envelope, a flat rate envelope. So I didn't know if it would arrive without like, who knows, damage. So yes, Andrew has a good point. Mail from Canada might not be going up in price. You'll have to check their postal system. That is very true. But going international, like to Canada, is going up just a little bit, like if you're sending your cards. It looks like just 5 cents overall. If you're using forever stamps, it shouldn't be an issue. There are even global forever stamps, so that will cover all of your international postage rates there too. I will check with the post office if the stamps I have will still work. Not sure if they are forever ones or not. LOL. Thanks for looking it up. If it says forever on the stamp, absolutely, it's a forever stamp. If it does not say forever and it has numbers on it, it is only the face value. So if you have a stamp that says 45 on it or 42 or something like that, it's only 42 cents. But if it says forever on it, that means it is a forever stamp. Now, if you're looking at very, very old vintage stamps, some of them don't have any number on them, or it might have like an A or a B. For those, you'd have to look up that specific stamp to see what the face value of it was when it was released. Most of the time, they're worth like, you know, like 20 cents or 23 cents or something like that. So you just have to look it up. I have some of those in my collection, and I generally just, I don't bother looking it up. I generally use them if I need it for something, you know, to just look nice for colors. So at that point, I already have postage taken care of, so that's just extra. Andrew says, I went stamp shopping and saw pretty stamps, but they weren't forever 1 ounce stamps. Bummer. Were they like vintage then? They weren't current? Is that what you mean? Because that could totally be the case. All right, I think I'm going to wrap this up for the night. Thank you all so much for joining me. I'll take some photos of these cards. Just getting some of these little fuzzies off. Like I can see them hanging out. I'm like, what is going on? All the little fuzzies from the die cut. I'll take photos of these, and I will update the supply section down below as well. And here we are. It's all good. Thanks for joining me. I will see you guys in a mail call video very soon. Thanks so much for joining me tonight. Have a great night. And a 4th of July if you're celebrating, if you're in the U.S. Have a great holiday. Thanks for joining me.